Hello world and welcome back to Olympic Winter Games Daily. I'm Dom Kim and today in our studio we have a freestyle skier who won Estonia's first ever medal in freestyle skiing. Guys, it's Kelly Sildaru. Welcome to the show.
Thank you. Hi.
Hi, good to see you. I mean, Kelly, this was your first ever Olympics. I mean, you were trying to go to PyeongChang but you had a knee injury. But of course, you came back strong. You got a gold medal in Lausanne 2020, and now you made it here in Beijing with your medal here. Tell us, what is it like to be here in Beijing?
It's been great so far. It's been a really great experience, and I'm happy that I made this. I made it here this year, because like of course, like during the whole season, I was a little worried if I'm gonna maybe injure myself, and the same thing would happen to me that happened in 2018 or 2017. So yeah, I was a little nervous, but I made it here, I'm healthy, and that's good.
We're gonna play a game, and it's called Would You Rather. Are you ready?
I am.
All right, I'm gonna start easy. Question number one. Would you rather be too cold or too hot?
Probably too hot.
Huh, okay.
I think I prefer like summer a little more than winter and like warm, because yeah, it's I would love if we could like do freestyle skiing in like summer conditions in a warm. It would be so nice.
All right, question number two. Would you rather stop time or go back in time?
That's a hard one. Probably stop the time.
All right, question number three. Would you rather have wings or mermaid tails?
I think wings. I think like wings are maybe a little prettier than like the tail. And you could fly.
All right, question number four. This is going to be a bit tricky. Would you rather have someone to see all your photos or read out all your texts?
I think so, all my photos.
Okay.
Yeah?
You have nothing to hide in your photo album.
I probably have, but I think I have like more stuff to hide in my texts. So, yeah. I
feel you. Well, question number five. Would you rather be 1 year older or younger?
I think I'd rather be older.
Okay.
Yeah, because I've been younger already, so maybe it's now time to like grow up and be older.
Well, question number six already. Would you rather eat sweets or crisps?
Crisps?
Chips.
Chips, oh, okay. I don't know. I like both of them, but I think I'd rather eat sweets.
All right, you're more a sweet tooth than a savory. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, probably, yeah.
Question number seven. Would you rather find something that you lost or find something that's brand new?
Probably that something I have lost. Because I always hate when I lose something. And like, it's always such a nice feeling when you find it again. So yeah.
All right, more about food. Question number eight. Would you rather have breakfast for every meal or dinner for every meal?
Dinner.
Huh. And yeah. What's your go-to dinner?
I don't know, pasta?
Yeah. You make your own pasta?
I do most of the time. But I also, like back home, I like to order some pasta. And I also really like sushi, so.
All right, question number nine. We're back to social media, or from. Would you rather never use social media again, like never, or never watch another movie again?
Never watch a movie.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not like such a big fan of movies anymore, actually. I'm more like a serious type of person. So yeah, I don't know. I even don't know when was the last time I watched a movie. So, oh, actually when we came here on the airplane. Okay. But I could have like watched so many different series as well at the same time, so.
So you're more TV shows than movies.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I see. Well, we have last but not least question number 10. Would you rather not be able to travel or not be able to listen to music?
not be able to listen to music.
Okay, so travel is more important for you.
Yeah, I think like it means a lot more when you're traveling, you can see the world, but like when you're listening to music, I mean, yeah, it would suck if we couldn't travel.
Now, moving back to the conversation, you were also the flag bearer for Estonia, and it's surprising and it's amazing that you are a flag bearer for your first ever Olympics. Tell us, what was it like when you entered a stadium with the flag?
It felt really amazing. Just like pretty much me holding the flag, and then like the whole team, Estonian team behind us or behind me, and walking into the stadium, it just felt so amazing. I think it's really hard to describe the feeling.
Were you nervous?
I was a little bit actually, yeah, because I didn't know what to expect. But I think it was a really cool and fun experience.
And of course, now you have the medal in your neck. What were you thinking when you realized that you just won a medal in your first ever Winter Olympic Games?
I think I'm kind of still in a shock, and I think I haven't realized yet. It's probably gonna happen when I'm going back home and see all my family and everybody like being so happy for me. Then I'll probably realize that I actually won an Olympic medal. Yeah.
You must have received lots of messages from your families and friends or somebody like you didn't expect coming from. Like, was there any message that you did not imagine that it will come from?
Yeah, I've got so many different messages from my fans, just like from random people in Estonia who were cheering on me, friends, family. Also Estonian president and prime minister.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow. You had many, many moments here in Beijing, but also you turned 20 years old very recently. How did you celebrate your birthday?
I had half my qualifications on the same day. So yeah, that's how I celebrated, I guess. yeah, that's pretty much it, I guess. I got some flowers and birthday cake. Yeah, I mean, I think it was really nice way like to turn older or turn 20.
What's the first thing that you want to do when you go back home?
Hug my dog.
Oh, Husky.
Yeah.
What's the name?
Kira.
She's adorable.
Yeah, she is. She's so lovely.
So your first thing you're going to do is to hug the Husky. Mm-hmm. And what's the first thing that you're going to eat? Is it pasta?
Probably, or sushi.
What was your favorite moment in Beijing 2022, if you had to choose one?
I think the moment I got my bronze medal, it's probably my favorite one.
What was the emotion like when you saw the medal in your hand?
Well, first, like right after the competition, when we had the ceremony, I mean, I knew I was third, but it didn't feel like real yet. So yeah, when I had the medal around my neck, it felt so much more real. And I'm just proud of myself.
What's next for you?
I don't have any plans yet. I would probably like to take a little time off and just rest a little bit. I'm probably just still gonna do maybe one or two comps this season. But then I'm gonna rest a little bit, yeah, during the summer.
And we're very looking forward to seeing the life and the career ahead of you. It's going to be incredible. Well, thank you so much for joining us this lovely chat today, Kelly.
Thank you.
And for our fans out there, thank you so much for all your warm love and support throughout this journey in Beijing 2022. Your support has truly warmed our winter here. So please continue following our journey in the Olympics and also Olympics.com. Thank you so much. And this was the Olympic Winter Games Daily.